the hole here.
A hole here with a piece of foil.
A pinhole in the foil. Yeah. Then you look through here.
And you put a piece of white tape on the bottom, which gives you your screen.
Okay.
And then the reflection comes through the pinhole, and you can see it inside on the screen.
What do you do for a living?
I'm an artist.
So not a scientist?
No.
All right, please don't burn your eyes. Okay, very good. And by the way, we have bigger ones here, too. This gentleman has a giant box, and it looks like it was a delivery from his apartment building. He's in apartment 408, by the way, if you need him. Anyway, so we're out here, and if you have the eclipse glasses, if you're still in the zone, by the way, just a really quick reminder, we've been saying this for a couple of weeks now. You want to look for the name of the manufacturer on the glasses. Make sure it's part of the approved list. You want to look over here where it says, these are the magic words for you, Craig, ISO, zoom in there, you got it, ISO 12312-2, and then you want to make sure that it's on the approved list, and it says that, and if you can see anything, we've been saying this all day, if you can see any light, your hands in front of your face, when these are on, that means they're scratched or there's something wrong, it should be pitch black, except when you look up at the sun, and I can tell you right now, guys, Sam and Craig, we have a definite beautiful partial eclipse here in New York right now, and it's the clouds have come over just a little bit, but for most of the day, we are getting a beautiful view here.
All right, Jeff Rawson. Jeff, thank you. That man with the Raisin Bran box may be able to see the eclipse just fine, but if he ate six bowls of Raisin Bran to create that box, he may have some other issues later this afternoon into the evening. Tom Costello, still aboard the USS Yorktown. Tom, it sure was great to hear so many people scream and cheer and shout. We had pictures of people crying, their hands up to the sky as the sun became overshadowed by the moon.
I think the consensus here, I'm going to ask these folks here, hey guys, the consensus, was it kind of a letdown with the clouds, or was it better?
It was still great.
It was, wasn't it? And what about the lightning show we had at the same time?
Oh, yeah, it was nice seeing both. Even though the lightning kind of got me seeing more of the lightning than...
Yeah, the lightning was a big distraction.
Yeah.
But the clouds just parted at just the right time.
Perfect timing.
Yes.
Yeah. What did you say?
Perfect timing. It was just beautiful.
And you had the line. What did you say?
A sense of drama.
Yeah, they saved the best for last, right? It was like the curtain pulling back at just the right moment. And, you know, like we said, with that cloud cover, it just kind of turned it all of a blue color, a blue hue, and then the lightning, it was spectacular, Craig.
Tom Costello there in Charleston, South Carolina. Tom, thank you so much for that, and please tell all the folks down there in God's country, hello, Sam Champion. Wow. What an afternoon.
Hi, thank you for letting me be here.
Thank you.
To watch it all across the country, and you heard everybody react exactly the same way.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, about halfway through our coverage, I realized it was, for a lot of these folks, this will be, scratch that, for nearly all of the folks, this will be the first and last time during the course of their lives, of our lives, will experience something like this.
Yeah, you get a solar eclipse about every 18 months somewhere, but remember how much of the Earth is water. So many of them that happen, no one gets a chance to see it. When you get one that runs coast to coast across America, across any country, it's a big deal. It's a huge deal. And everyone got a chance to see it today.
And this isn't over, right? As you indicated, I mean, a lot of these communities